actually 4 Sundays of Lent, then a Passion Sunday, followed by a Palm Sunday. Christ's celebration, Christ's crucifixion were separate. But after a liturgical edict in 1969, the church cramped Palm and Passion together in one liturgical endeavor, and now church life embodies your life. Any single day, you and I are people of mixed messages and emotions, highs and lows, joys and griefs, successes and failures. Both gospel and sin reside deep within us. Dietrich Bonhoeffer wrote, "Disciples wander on the earth and live in heaven. And although they are weak, they protect the world, taste of peace in the midst of turmoil. They are poor, yet they have all they want. They stand in suffering, and yet remain in joy. They appear dead to all outward sense, and yet lead a life of faith within." Today, two Gospels reveal starkly different images of Christ, and the two Gospels reveal starkly different images of disciples. In the first, disciples who usually are clueless, confused, and complaining, it seems like for the first time ever, do exactly what Jesus asked. They publicly raised and praised Jesus as their king. But in the second gospel, the exact opposite. That last line, heartbreaking. But all his acquaintances, including the women who had followed him from Galilee, stood at a distance, watching these things. You know that phrase, "at a distance," is found throughout Luke. All his acquaintances today stood at a distance when Jesus was led away to die. Peter the rock, the chief of the disciples, followed at a distance.